ordained and God placed and God put. The word says that God is seated on his holy throne. Church, what God already ordained and what God already foretold, it's a done deal. From the very beginning to the very end, it doesn't matter if we feel like we're slapped down in the middle. I'm telling you, God knows how to take us through.
Take us through.
Through the rivers, through the storms, through the heartaches, break aches, back aches, I'm telling you, foot aches. Oh, don't take me there. But I'm telling you, God is sitting on his throne that the nobles of the nations assemble. God assembled, God placed, and God's put as the people of the God of Abraham. He assembles, he placed, he puts, he organizes, he orchestrates even things you don't know. Well, you're going to find out to know, come on now, and you're going to overcome. Those are those overcoming those hurdles, overcoming those circumstances, overcoming all these things. Why? Because he has subdued these nations under us. He has placed us and he has put people under our feet. For even the king himself, he said, the earth is my footstool. I just said a word right there. The earth is my footstool. That's the Lord. And God reigns over all the nations. And he is seated on his holy throne that the nobles of the nations assemble and the people of God of Abraham. For the king of the earth belong to God. The kings of the earth belong to God. He is greatly exalted. See, God has called us to be these great ambassadors because he's the great king, the big king of kings. He's the Lord of lords. Come on now. And he has subdued and at hand. And I'm telling you, we have to receive it and activate it with joy. And I know I'm running fast, and my daughter says, no, no, you're not. She always says that. But I just want to affirm just a little bit. Now, you can read it again and what the Lord gives unto you. But I'm just going to share just a little bit out of Philippians 4. Where the Lord says in 4, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. See, you have something to shout about. You have something to be glad about. You have something to have a pep in your step, a smile on your face, because we rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. That let your gentleness be evident to all because the Lord is near. Come on now. Yeah. And so we're not going to be anxious about anything because that's what the enemy wants. We're not going to be anxious about when and how and what and where. We're not going to be anxious. But it says in every situation, this is by prayer, this is by petition, this is by thanksgiving, this is us about presenting your request to God. And then once you request it to God, you know what? Take your peace. Take your peace because the word is saying, and the peace of God, which transcends all these things, understanding is going to guard your heart. It's going to guard your mind until all the things that you prayed about come to pass. And I'm telling you, God knows how to be an on-time God. Tell your neighbor he's an on-time God. I don't know about you, but he's never failed me yet. It may not be when you want it, but it'll be here right on time. Because God is good. You know what? all the time. And John 14, the word says, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe. We're what? We're the believers. So you believe. You believe in God. And he says, believe also in me. Because in my Father's house, there's many rooms. And if that were not said so, would I have not told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? Wow, doesn't that sound almost like an Abraham and an Isaac sacrifice, that I prepared a place for you, that I have the offering for you? But we're being tested. We're being pruned. We're being cut on. But I'm telling you, God knows exactly when, exactly how. But can you trust me? Trust me. Because in my Father's house, there's many rooms. And if it were not said, I would not have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you. That's a promise. And if I go and I prepare a place for you, I'm going to come back. And so that's another promise. And then I'm going to take you with me. That's another promise. That you also may be where I am. See, he always wants to be where I am. Because our love should be the same, that it's not only that I love you, I love you, I love you, but that he loves me. That he loves me too. Because you know the way and the place where I am going. Church, I'm going to wrap it up right there. Because I know that God has a place for you.
Yes.
And a place for me. And I
pray
through every circumstance, every situation, every heartache, that if you're being anxious about something, pray about it, request it, give it to God, and let God answer it. Because the more that we hold on to it, we're not really truly giving it to God. Like, let me give you this gift, but yet I'm holding on to it. Are you going to let go so I can give it to you? Because you made the request. So let me give it to you. Give it to you. Who needs it? Who needs it? Take it. Receive it. Your request. Give it into the hands of God. Let us stand to our feet. You know, God never surprises, because God always shows up. He's never late. He's always on time. It's not about us. It's always about him. And as long as we continue to walk with him and do for him and act for him, he's always going to lead the way. And that way is always to the straight and narrow way. So just we continue to surrender our hearts and surrender our lives. And ask God just to use you in a mighty way in your coming and your going. And we thank you, Lord, for that here today. Father, we honor you. We glorify you. And we praise your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for the word of peace as well as the word of joy. That our joy may be full, that we will lack or slack and nothing. That we rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. How many times does he have to remind us to rejoice And that we cast all cares upon the Lord, because Father, you care for us. You love us. And you've showed us time and time again throughout your promises that you're never late, that you're always on time. We thank you, Lord, for the covering, the blessing, the blood of Jesus over this house and over our lives and our coming and our going, Father God. We thank you, Lord, that you're always an on-time God. We thank you, Lord, for the lives of the family that have stepped into this place. We know that there's no distance in prayer. Of all the men and women that have came in and literally filled the house, Lord, let them keep in remembrance of who you are within their lives. Bless them immensely, Father God. And may they find their way back to you, Father. Back to you. Surrendering and giving their heart back to you. We pray for our loved ones, those that are far and those that are near, have your way within their lives. Father God, we leave all the missions, we leave all the conferences, we leave all these things in your hands. We thank you, Lord, for revival in our third world nations, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for Pakistan and all the pastors that you're working with and elevating and building up. We thank you, Lord, for Nigeria ambassador and prophets, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all the work and the construction, Father. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings, Lord, that are building up your houses, Father. As we unite and commence all these wonderful things in your name and all the wonderful things that you're doing within our lives. You know, without you, we are nothing, Lord. May you continually to do your work mightily upon the land as long as we have breath. Father, may we forever praise your name, Lord. Praise your name. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. If you got an offering to give it unto the Lord, amen. Thank you, Jesus. If God has put anything upon your heart to be able to give, I want to thank all those that have come across our social media platforms. Amen. Tina Viesca, Crossing Borders International, Cruzando Fronteras con una voz alerta. Don't forget to like and share the page. Amen. And getting into all of our ways of forth and our giving. We want to see you. Amen. Don't forget, if you are in the surrounded area and maybe you need a church, you're more than welcome to fellowship with us. We have Sunday at 10:30. Then on Tuesday, English speaking today. The Lord led me just go ahead and do all English with a little bit of Spanish, amen. Tuesdays, all English on Tuesday, and then Thursdays. Sometimes if we're not literally in the house, I'll be sharing a broadcast that will put you in at that time, amen, so that we are able to celebrate and to get into this word, amen. So God bless you. Y'all guys have a wonderful and safe time and week, amen. And may the Lord bless you, and may his face shine upon you greatly, amen. Until next time, church, we love you. Hallelujah. God bless you, church. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you for all those that have came into the house, amen. We love you. Until next time. Bye, Instagram fam. We love you. Thank you, speaker fam. We love you, church.
Levanta la mano al cielo conmigo, repite.